Students, in the past few video lectures, we have learned about intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductors. Intrinsic semiconductors are pure semiconductor, and extrinsic semiconductors are formed by doping. And extrinsic semiconductors can be p-type or n-type. And we have learned the characteristics of p-type and n-type semiconductors also in the previous video lectures. In a p-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers are holes, and in n-type semiconductors, majority charge carriers are electrons. And in today's session, we will be learning about p-n junction diode, which is an instrument, electronic device, which is constructed by using p-type and n-type semiconductor. P-n junction diode. What does this mean, and how a junction diode is constructed? What are the uses of junction diode? All these will be learned in this video session. We know a p-type semiconductor has majority charge carriers holes, and a n-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers are electrons. P-type and n-type semiconductors, if you see them separately, majority charge carriers are holes and majority charge carriers are electrons in n-type. Now, a p-n junction diode is formed by joining these two, by joining p-type and n-type semiconductors. Practically, it does not mean that you are taking a p-type, you are taking a n-type, putting a Fevicol in between them, that become p-n junction diode. Absolutely wrong. It's not like that. You cannot join two semiconductors as if you are joining two wooden blocks. So construction of p-n junction diode is quite different than that of what we generally do. So for construction of p-n junction diode, we will be taking a pure semiconductor. So we will be taking a pure semiconductor. This is pure semiconductor. And this pure semiconductor is divided into two parts. Two parts, like just only the spacing is divided. You are not cutting it into two parts. You are taking a pure semiconductor and you are just geometrical separation, like half part and half part. You are just geometrically separating that, not exactly cutting it. Now, this pure semiconductor, after considering as two partitions, you will dope this first part with trivalent impurities. And you will dope the second part with pentavalent impurities. Okay, so you are taking a pure semiconductor. First half part, you are doping it with trivalent impurities, and the next half part you are doping it with pentavalent impurities. When you are doping first part with trivalent impurities, obviously this part, majority charge carriers are holes, therefore it become p-type extrinsic semiconductor. And the second part, you are doping it with a pentavalent impurities. As a result, majority charge carriers become electrons, so this become n-type semiconductor. Now, p-type and n-type. So in one pure semiconductor, you are doping a pure semiconductor with two impurities, trivalent impurities and as well as pentavalent impurities in the separate sections. That forms a combination of p-type and n-type semiconductor, which is said to be as a junction diode. And this p-n junction diode has multiple uses in electronics, in electronic devices, in almost all electronic devices. We will be using this p-n junction diode. It has multiple uses. And uses of junction diode will be learnt in the next section. First, let us learn how conduction is taking place in case of a p-n junction diode. Now, this is the schematic diagram which is shown in the figure. The schematic diagram of p-type and n-type semiconductors is like this. Now, in case of p-type semiconductor, these all are holes. These are holes. They are treated to be positive, and these are electrons. They are treated to be as negative. Now, you have made a pure semiconductor into partition and doping it with trivalent and pentavalent impurities so that n-type and p-type are formed in the same conductor, same semiconductor. Now, what actually happens at this position where there is the interface, this is the interface between impurities which you are adding. So you will be doping with trivalent from one side, pentavalent from the other side, but at the joining, like at this position, at this point, this region, this side it is more number of electrons, and this side it is more number of holes. As a result, see, we are not dividing the whole semiconductor into two parts. So therefore, what would happen as these electrons which are present here on this side, they are able to move towards this. This electron is also able to move towards this. This electron is also able to move towards this. As a result, one hole is formed here. As a result, one hole is formed here. As a result, one hole is being formed here. Like that, some electrons from n-type region will be drifted to p-type region in order to occupy the holes which are present in p-type. And the holes are being generated in n-type last, like ending region of the n-type semiconductor, holes are being generated over there. So now, like this, electrons from here, they get shifted into this region. We call it as diffusion. We call this process as diffusion. Because of diffusion, electrons are moving from N region to P region, not all electrons, only those electrons which are closer to P region. And because the electrons are moving here, as a result, they are being diffused. Because of diffusion, some current is developed. That current is said to be as diffusion current. The current is said to be as diffusion current. And as a result, in this region, like as in case of p-type, in this region, all electrons are being occupied. Right? So, electrons are coming over here. So, these all electrons which are present, they are being occupied here. As a result, this part become negative. And this part become positive. And this region, in this complete region, the electrons and holes are now being recombined. Of electrons and holes are taking place due to diffusion. So due to diffusion, the electrons and holes are being recombined in this region. Therefore, this region is said to be free of charge carriers. So this region, this middle region, which is closer to the point partition, that region is free of charge carriers because all electrons and holes are recombined. So therefore it is said to be free of charge carriers. And this region is called depletion region. It is called depletion region. This region is depletion region, usually denoted with capital D. D is depletion region. Now as electrons and holes are being recombined in the depletion region, so all the electrons from n-type cannot enter into p-type. All the holes will not be entering from p-type to n-type. So there are only few electrons which are recombined at the depletion region. Such a way, this part, this total part is now completely negative charged, and this total part is now completely positive charged. That means positive charged, positive charged carriers, I say. It's not actually positive charge, negative charge carriers. So one side it is all holes and the other side it is all electrons. They are being blocked by depletion region such that no more electron can enter from n-type to p-type. So as there is depletion region formed, this electron which is in this region, this electron cannot be enter into p-type. This electron cannot overcome the depletion region width and it cannot enter into p-type. So as a result, this is not possible. This is not possible. Remaining electrons will remain as it is in the n-type and holes will remain as it is in the p-type, except the region where depletion is being formed. Only in that region electron holes are recombined. And that is said to be free of charge carriers. So hence it is depletion region. No more electrons from n-type can cross the width of depletion region and enter into p-type. So because one part is completely filled with negative charged carriers and the other part of this semiconductor is completely filled with holes, there comes a potential barrier in between these regions. So this is one potential region V1 and this is one potential region V2, and this potential difference which is said to be observed here is called as potential barrier. It is called potential barrier, right? So potential barrier mean that there is some potential difference generated within the PN junction diode such that electrons and holes should overcome the potential barrier width in order to travel from n-type to p-type or p-type to n-type. This is the way a PN junction diode is being formed by adding trivalent and pentavalent impurities to a pure semiconductor in particular format. See in the animation clearly, you are taking a p-type and n-type semiconductor, like p-type and n-type are being formed in a pure semiconductor. This is initially. As a result, when they come closer, electrons will be occupying the whole region such that a region which is being recombined by positive and negative charges is said to be depletion region. And there a potential barrier is being generated, and that potential barrier will block no more electrons to come from n-type to p-type. This is how a PN junction diode is being formed. So students, we already have seen how a PN junction diode is being formed. In case of a PN junction diode, in middle region where electrons and holes form a potential barrier, electrons and holes cannot again come from n-type to p-type or p-type to n-type, there comes a potential barrier. Now in this animation which is seen, this region is hole, like this region is electrons, so therefore it become n-type, and this region is holes, therefore it is said to be positive, it is p-type. Now observe carefully, no electron from n-type is entering into p-type. No electron is able to enter from n-type to p-type. In order to enter from p-type to n-type, it should overcome this barrier width. This is the potential barrier, this region. In order to come one electron from this region to this region, you need to provide the potential difference delta V, which is equal to potential barrier of the junction diode. Okay, and that potential barrier width depends upon the nature of semiconductors, which type of semiconductors you are adding, and also p-type and n-type when you are constructing, what are the dopants which you are including. So on these all factors, the potential barrier width depends on. Usually it should be in the order of 1 electron volt, not more than that. So if it is in the order of 1 electron volt, easily external potential difference when it is being provided to electrons in n-type, they can cross the barrier and enter into p-type, which makes conduction possible. And the symbol of p-n junction diode is this. This is the symbol of p-n junction diode. It is p-type and this is n-type. P-type is connected with one terminal, n-type is connected with another terminal, and these two terminals are commonly connected to a battery. You can connect these two terminals to a battery, which makes conduction possible in case of a p-n junction diode. So these are the important points you need to keep it in your mind regarding potential barrier and as well as junction diode. Biasing a junction diode, that means the two terminals of a junction diode is connected to a battery. When you are connecting a junction diode to a battery, what would happen, right? So there are two possible ways which you can connect a junction diode. Say this is a junction diode, it is p-type and it is n-type. It has two terminals. P-type of the junction diode can be connected to positive terminal of the battery. N-type can be connected to negative terminal of the battery. Okay, p-type is connected to positive terminal of the battery, n-type is connected to negative terminal of the battery. This kind of biasing is called forward bias. Forward bias of a junction diode. This is number one. And the other way which you can bias the junction diode is, you will be taking a junction diode. This is p-type and this is n-type. P-type of the junction diode is connected to negative terminal, and n-type of the junction diode is connected to positive terminal. And this is called reverse bias. Biasing a junction diode can be two ways. One is forward bias and the other one is reverse bias. In case of forward bias, p-type is connected to positive. And in case of reverse bias, p-type is connected to negative terminal of the battery, right? So p-type is connected to negative terminal and p-type is connected to positive terminal in forward bias and in reverse bias, right? Now let us see what happens in case of forward bias. So when you are considering a junction diode in forward bias, you are taking this positive p-type region and you are connecting it to a battery which is positive. And this is negative terminal, which is connected to negative terminal and along with the tap key. This is tap key. So when you switch on the tap key, as we know, this battery will provide some potential difference, and this is battery potential. And because of this battery potential, there is some electric field developed within the semiconductor, and this is E, electric field. Electric field will be always in the direction from positive to negative terminal. Okay. So as electric field is developed here within this semiconductor, because of that electric field, electrons will be drifted in opposite direction to that of electric field. Holes will be drifted in the direction of electric field. Now here, this is N region. As it is N region, the electron which is here, it is crossing the barrier and it is entering into p-type. This is crossing the barrier, entering into p-type. This is crossing the barrier, entering into p-type. So all the electrons which are present here in the N region, because of the drifting, they overcome the barrier width of semiconductor junction diode and they enter into p region. And from p region, as this is positive terminal, before recombination of p-type semi, like hole and electron, these electrons are dragged by electric field of this positive terminal. That's the reason why electrons from n region will be directly going in this direction. Right? So whenever electrons are moving from n type to p type, it means that conduction is possible. This makes conduction possible because of external electric field provided over there. Electrons will be drifted from n region to p region by overcoming the potential barrier of the junction diode. Say for example, you have germanium and silicon. If you are constructing a p-n junction diode in such a way, it is like a germanium, it is made up of germanium. Germanium have some potential barrier width of 0.7 electron volt. Sorry, silicon, it is 0.7 electron volt. Unless the electron in the n-type receive energy greater than 0.7 electron volt, it does not cross the barrier. Suppose if the battery potential which you are providing is 0.1 electron volt, conduction is not possible. Conduction is not possible here because potential of the battery is less than potential barrier of the junction diode. So if the battery potential is greater than the potential barrier width, then only conduction becomes possible. If not, conduction is not possible. So in order to travel electron from n region to p region, definitely the battery potential which you are providing, it should overcome the potential barrier width of the junction diode. So usually in case of this semiconductor, battery potential should be greater than 0.7 electron volt. Then only conduction become possible. Now in case of a junction diode which is connected in forward bias, there are some important conclusions which you can write down, and those conclusions I'll write it in the order. The first point is that in forward bias, junction diode conducts and it acts as a conducting wire. Therefore, we call it as electronic switch, and this is said to be switch on condition. And in the second case, where in forward bias, the width of the depletion region decreases because electrons are going from n region to p region. As a result, the width of depletion region decreases. That is number two. And number three, in forward bias, as electrons are able to be shifted from n region to p region, the conduction is greater. As conduction is greater, the forward resistance of the junction diode is usually less. So in forward bias, current in the semiconductor, current in the junction diode is maximum and the resistance in the diode is minimum. That is junction diode connected in forward bias. Therefore, a forward bias junction diode is said to be switch on condition. It acts as switch on in electronic devices. In the animation shown there, the total number of charge carriers in the semiconductor will remain same as it is. Law of conservation of charge is valid here also. You are not externally generating electrons or holes. Whatever the total number of electrons and holes which are present in that junction diode, they just will be transferred from one part to the other part. Because you are connecting potential difference here, electrons from N region will be shifted towards P region, and those electrons are being carried forward by the battery, and again they are being provided in the N type. So it is just the transfer of electrons within the whole circuit. You are not separately generating the electrons. So whenever electrons are able to move freely within the junction diode, it is said to be in forward bias, and that is called electronic switch on condition. So hence junction diode is used as electronic switch in many electrical circuits, many electronic circuits, not electrical. So that clearly been shown in this animation. Now, as I told you, junction diode in reverse bias, it is p-type connected to negative terminal, n-type connected to positive terminal of the battery, right? p-type is connected to negative terminal, n-type is connected to positive terminal. As a result, in which direction electric field is developed? Definitely it is from positive to negative. Electric field is in this direction. This is electric field. And in case of p-type, there are holes. And in case of n-type, there are electrons. These are the electrons which are here. Now, when you are connecting the junction diode in reverse bias, what would happen? Clearly, you can understand that electrons will be drifted in opposite direction to electric field. As a result, these electrons are forced to drift in this direction. And holes are allowed to travel in the direction of electric field. So therefore, these holes tend to move in the same direction of electric field. Holes will be moving in the same direction of electric field. Electrons will be moving in opposite direction to that of electric field. As a result, what is happening here? The electrons which are present in this region, they are being drifted outward. The holes which are present in this region, they are drifted outward. As a result, the width of depletion region goes on increases. Width of depletion region increases and no electron from n-type can enter into p-type. No electron can enter from n-type to p-type. So as no electron is entering from n-type to p-type, junction diode in reverse bias does not conduct. Therefore, current in the circuit will be equal to zero, and junction diode in reverse bias act as switch off in an electronic circuit, right? And whereas when the junction diode is connected in forward bias, it is acting as switch on, and here it is switch off. When it is a switch on, junction diode acts as a conductor, and in reverse bias, it is not at all allowing any current to flow. Therefore, resistance of junction diode in reverse bias increases as width of potential barrier increases. So resistance in case of reverse bias will be greater than that of resistance in case of forward bias. So resistance in reverse bias is greater than resistance in forward bias, right? And in reverse bias, the circuit diagram can be drawn like this. This is junction diode symbol. It is p-type and this is n-type. P-type is connected to negative of the battery. N-type is connected to positive of the battery. This is circuit diagram of junction diode in reverse bias, right? So this is how, in case of a junction diode, there will be no conduction when it is connected in reverse bias till you are applying some large negative potential. So as you are increasing the potential difference, what would happen? Electrons and holes are strongly moved in outward direction, which increases the width of depletion region. So therefore, even though you are increasing the potential difference, current will be zero. current in the junction diode in reverse bias will be obviously equal to zero. You can draw circuit diagrams of junction diode connected in forward bias and reverse bias like this. This is junction diode connected in forward bias, and this is junction diode connected in reverse bias. So in forward bias, current is maximum, I is equal to V divided by R net, and in reverse bias, I will be equal to zero.